I told the Chinese and the Vietnamese yesterday that the Quan Yin method, the spiritual practitioner of the Quan Yin method, will move mountains. Yes, will level the ocean with their power without doing anything. So just be patient, meditate, and world peace will come.
من دیروز به چینی ها گفتم اینو گفتم که کسانی که اینیشییت شدن و کوانین انجام میدن میتونن کوه و حرکت بدن میتونن همه چیز رو حرکت بدن به خاطر قدرتی که دارن فقط صبر داشته باشید مراقبه بکنید و اون وقت صلح جهانی میاد سراغ ما
There was great changes in China Great changes in Taiwan, great changes in Vietnam. Well, I cannot tell too many in different countries, but I just tell from the country that I know, huh? Great changes, great, how you say, improvement in these countries that nobody imagined it would happen before. The Taiwan and the China, they shook hands with each other. Every day the Chinese can come visit the Taiwan. It never happened for so long. It happened now, okay?
استاد می‌فرمایند که چین، تایوان، ویتنام درشون خیلی تغییر ایجاد شده در سال‌های گذشته. قبلاً کی فکر می‌کرد؟ هیچ کس نمی‌دونست که قرار چین و تایوان با هم دوست باشن. الان میرن و میان. خیلی تغییرات ایجاد شده.
Really, God knows what we want.
خداوند میدونه که ما چی میخوایم.
We just wait and see.
ما فقط صبر میکنیم.
Master, I have a comment.
Yes, say something. Yes, yes.
I live in United States and I want to say that I owe you my life. I thank you for everything.
You're welcome, love.
For everything.
Okay, then. Something good happened to you?
A lot of good things.
Okay.
And I have been initiated since September.
Only September.
And my life has changed since I did the convenient method.
Yes.
Day by day, I see changes. And it may not be apparent to other people,
yes.
but inside, I feel calm,
yes.
and I feel peace, and I owe it to you.
Oh, sorry, owe it to yourself.
And You're I good. Thank you. Yes. You have made me
wonderful,
confident and clever. And I thank you very much.
You're welcome. You're very welcome. Very welcome. Actually, of course you thank me, but I don't ever feel, I feel you should thank yourself, and I will be thanking you because you make the world different by your practice. If I'm alone, I cannot make much difference. Because of you, the world changed. In fact, even though it feels like we have war everywhere, but it's not like that. We have less war now than a few years before. More than 50% less. And it's going to be less and less and less all the time because people already waken up. They're fed up with war. They're fed up with violence. They realize now that only love, only peaceful means can really bring happiness to people. Including themselves, including the leaders. Yes.
باید اینو دونست که فقط با عشق میشه شادی را آورد. این بزرگترین پیامه.
50% less now, the war. More than 50%.
الان ما 50% کمتر جنگ داریم.
Yes. Even though it seems like still a lot of war, but it has less now. Just a few years and it become less and less and less.
اینم در عرض چند سال گذشته 50% کمتر.
World peace is really possible.
پس صلح جهانی واقعا امکان پذیره.
It is possible. It will come. Yep. هورا. It will come, yeah? People have to realize it one day. After so much suffering, people will realize it, that it's useless to have war, then peace must come.
مردم میفهمن که با جنگ هیچ چیزی جلو نمیره، اصلا بیخوده، پس صلح میادش.
Yeah, within nations also, and things will open, borders will open, yeah, country, nations will open to each other, people will shake hands, leaders will support each other, leaders will understand each other, and peace definitely will come, and very soon. Yes.
خیلی زود مرزها دیگه باز میشن، ملت‌ها با هم دست میدن و صلح جهانی میاد. خیلی خیلی زود.
Yes. We just have to be good. We just have to be positive about other people, about other nation, about the government, about anything. Yeah. Just get out the positive and things will become better. Yes.
ما باید خیلی مثبت باشیم، چیزای خوبو بگیریم و اون وقت صلح جهانی میادش.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, things will change. Okay? Don't worry. Yes. Right. I'm so happy that you can come. Can you imagine if you cannot come?
میگن خیلی خوشحالم که اومدی.
Yeah.
نمیتونستم تصور کنیم که
it's very good already of your government.
خیلی خوبه که yeah, تو برای دولتتون خوبه که شما اومد.
What left? You prayed 3 months?
Yes.
Well, that's not too long, is it?
No, but I've been initiated for 2 days.
Oh, okay.
That's what I saw you on SMTV on the 7th of September.
Oh, that's how you get initiated?
Yes.
Congratulations. The SMTV does help, huh?
It does.
You see, it's still a very good system. You could even watch internet. Your country is free. You even come out here to see me. Your country is free. It's, you can't have absolute freedom in every nation. Every nation has something, okay? So, but it's free enough that you come out, and it could be more free in the future. Yeah? Okay? Wonderful, wonderful. Congratulations. Congratulations. To thank your government also.
و باید تشکرم بکنیم از دولتتون.
Good government in this aspect.
دولت خوب میتونه این کارو بکنه. پس آزادی وجود داره و بیشتر هم خواهد.
It's a free world we live in. More free than before.
دنیای آزادیه که الان ما زندگی میکنیم و بیشتر از قبل آزادی داشتیم.
We count our blessing.
ما لطف خداوند، رحمت خداوند رو میشماریم.
Yeah, we know. We count the positive blessing that we have.
ما این رحمت خداوند و رحمت الهی رو که مثبت میشماریم.
All right. Any more questions? Yeah, there you are. They ask very intelligent question. They ask very intelligent question. The person.
یعنی سوالای خیلی هوشمندانه میپرسید.
So your country cannot be that bad.
پس کشورتون نمیتونه بد باشه.
Yeah, your system must have been good.
از سیستمتون میتونه درست باشه. درست
بوده. To some degree. Yes. Okay. This girl and then the man. All right. Yeah.
و اینکه میخواستم ازتون تشکر کنم به خاطر صحبت‌های آرامش بخشتون و مژدگانی قشنگتون.
And I would like to thank you for your the way you give us the speeches so peacefully and they calm me down and good news that you gave us about the world peace.
You're welcome. Can you bring this home and give to the people at home, if whomever you can?
Thank you,
Master.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay. Thank you, Master.
How old is she?
13.
13 only? Since and you speak so good?
Thank you, Master.
I'm proud.
The education system is very tough.
Tough?
Yeah, I mean you've got to study all the time practically, and there is if you want to go to university, you've got to pass a very very
hard test. Wow, no
very
wonder.
Very hard test.
No wonder.
So people study an awful lot because that's one way to freedom.
Ah,
one way or
wonderful,
another.
Wonderful, wonderful,
wonderful. Thank you, Master.
Yeah. At least it has a good point, huh? So what I mean is, your people. They speak very articulate. I mean, the old and the young. So your culture must be very, prestigious then.
استاد میفرمایند که از آدم کم سن و پر سن و فرق نمیکنه ولی همتون خیلی قشنگ صحبت میکنیم پس باید خیلی فرهنگ غنی داشته باشیم.
So if you go back to your country, if I may advise you once, just relax.
اگر وقتی که رفتید به منزلتون به خونتون فقط یاد بگیرید که آرامش داشته باشید، ریلکس کنید.
Whatever happened, just relax.
هر چیزی که اتفاق قراره بیفته، فقط ریلکس کنید.
Don't let the pressure, any pressure, get onto you.
اجازه ندید که هیچ فشاری به شما آسیبی برسونه.
And even if you feel the pressure, you should know that is a motivation to push you more on the spiritual height.
حتی اگر فشاری رو احساس میکنین بدونین فقط یک انگیزه ایه که برای شما خیلی سریعتر توی راه معنویتتون پیشرفت کنید.
So just thank Allah for whatever happened. Just thank Allah every day.
از خداوند تشکر کنید برای هر چیزی که اتفاق میفته.
You come here for a holiday. You're on the beach. You can walk to the beach. And you come home, and if anybody asks, say, I've been on Pattaya Beach, I had a good time. Yeah, Thailand is a wonderful hospital country, and I met some very nice friends.
استاد میفهمن هر کس از شما پرسید بگین که من رفتم به سواحل پاتایا توی تایلند.
It's true.
و رفتم یه چند تا دوستم پیدا کردم خیلی خوب بود رفتم لب دریا همه جا رو گشتم هیچ نگرانی هم نداشته باشید.
Have a big smile and say, come to Thailand, you, yourself, whoever asks.
بعد یک لبخند خیلی بزرگی داشته باشید و بگین بیاین برین تو تایلند جای خوبی برای گردن.
Yeah, I recommend Pattaya Beach. Yeah, wonderful.
بسیار عالی. Thank you, Master. Thank you.
Just relax. Be positive.
فقط آسوده باشید، ریلکس بکنید و مثبت باشید.
Sometimes things are not as bad as we imagine.
گاهی مسائل اونقدر به اون بدی که ما فکر میکنیم نیست.
Sometimes we are so used to with the negative influence, we forget that there's Allah who watch over us and don't let nothing happen to us.
گاهی ما اینقدر تحت تاثیر نیروهای منفی قرار میگیریم که یادمون میره که در واقع خداونده که داره ما رو نگاه میکنه و از ما حمایت میکنه.
We must hang on to him.
باید به اون متوسل بشین و توکل داشته باشید.
Recite the holy names all the time.
پنج نام مقدس و مرتب بگید.
Any situation.
در هر موقعیتی.
Yes. Even if it really happened that something happened to us, look at the prophet. They're great, but they suffer also.
حتی اگرم اتفاقی برای ما بیفته یادتون باشه حتی به پیامبران نگاه بکنید که خیلی رنج و زحمت کشیدن و بردن.
But that even make them greater. People try to destroy him and he become more famous than ever. Jesus, Muhammad, Buddha. People try to destroy them. Instead, they make them a hero, a martyr, and they live forever. Many centuries, people still pray to them.
حتی اگر بدترین کارها را برای اونا میکردن برای این پیامبران ولی اونا رو بیشتر نامشون رو زنده تر کردن و اونا رو موفق تر کردن.
And they are high in the spiritual heavens.
بعد اون وقت اینا در مقامات بالای معنویت هستن.
Where no blame, no fame, no suffering can ever touch them.
که اون وقت هیچ تقصیری هیچ شهرتی یا بدنامی میتونه بهشون آسیبی برسونه.
There is a risk in everything.
در هر چیزی ریسکی هستش.
When you marry, you risk.
وقتی ازدواج میکنی
your freedom.
ریسک میکنی.
You risk your freedom. Yeah. There's a boy, you know, 5 years old. He asked his father, "Father, is it very does it cost a lot to get married, to be married?" The father say, "I don't know, son. I'm still paying for it."
یه پسری از پدرش میپرسه که خیلی به اصطلاح خرج داره که آدم ازدواج بکنه و اینا، بعد پدره به پسرش میگه که نمیدونم پسرم، من هنوزم دارم بابتش پول میدم.
Yeah. When you're in love, you also take in risk.
وقتی عاشقی ریسک هم برمی‌داری.
Yeah, because the person you are in love with may be not that in love with you.
خاطر اینکه امکان داره کسی رو که دوست داری عاشق تو اونقدر نباشه.
He might look like, but maybe she's not in love with you.
امکان داره که اون عاشقت نباشه.
You give everything, your heart, your soul, your freedom, everything, but you don't know what you get back. See?
همه چی تو میدی، قلبت و روحت و آزادی تو میدی، امکان داره هیچی هم در مقابلش نگیری.
Some marriages are very happy, some are not, but you never know until later, no?
بعضی از ازدواج ها امکان داره خوشحالی و شادی درش باشه، بعضی ها نه، ولی تو نمیدونی تا اینکه بعدها بفهمی.
And when you decide to have children, you take another risk.
وقتی تصمیم میگیری بچه دار بشی، خیلی ریسک برمیداری در زندگی.
You never know if your children are going to be good to you, filial to you, or be good student or not.
نمیدونی که آیا بچه ها برای تو بچه های خوبی خواهند شد یا دانشجو و دانش آموزای خوبی خواهند بود. هیچی در موردشون نمیدونی.
And if you have a daughter, it's even more risky.
و اما اگر دختر داشته باشی ریسکش بالاتره.
You know what I mean.
شما میدونی من چی میگم.
Yeah. And when you open a business, an enterprise, you risk your capital. You don't know if you're going to be profit. You know, you have profit in your business or not. You never know. Anything is a risk. Huh?
همه چیز ریسک داره. حتی اگر یه شرکتی یه بیزنسی رو باز بکنی، نمیدونی که آیا آخرش سودی میبری یا نه. Yeah. ریسکی.
Yes. But we have to do what our heart say to us. Yeah?
پس باید با تمام قلبمون بگیم برای خودمون.
So by coming here, if your heart tell you, if your soul tell you that is good for your spiritual practice, if you good for your soul, and if in the name of Allah, if you feel it is a righteous thing to do, then it's okay to take a risk.
اگه با روحتون با قلبتون تمام احساس کردید که این خوبه براتون و اون خواست خداست و چیزی بوده که شما هم میخواین، پس بدونین که خوبه.
All the prophets, they take risk.
تمام پیامبران ریسک برداشتن.
Not even for themselves.
نه برای خودشون.
Yeah. For everybody else.
برای کسانی دیگه.
So it's okay if we take risk, at least for our soul, our family, our generations.
پس اوکیه، مشکلی نیستش که ریسک برداری برای خودت، برای خانوادت و برای نسلت.
And maybe it's the best thing you ever did.
شاید بهترین کاری بوده که تا حالا تو عمرت کردی.
Maybe it's not a risk at all.
شاید هم حتی اصلا ریسک نباشه.
Yeah, okay. Okay. No problem.
Yeah.
I think no problem, huh? I think the whole world know what we are right now. They can even check us from internet. I think since the time I have taken over this job, I don't think I have ever done anything wrong to this world or to anybody. So if they check us, they think, okay, you are my friend, I don't think any problem will come out of that. They probably think, ah, well, at least Qinghai is okay. if we're there with Qinghai, it's okay. What I mean, if they find out that you are with Qinghai, they think, well, at least, you know, they are with the okay woman.
اگر کسی بفهمه که شما با استاد هستید، اقلا میدونن که اوکیه، شما با منید. به هر حال منو میشناسن.
Nowadays they can check everybody.
این روزا همه کسو میتونن چک کنن.
Any government, any
هر دولتی، هر کسی.
Check inside out.
از زیر و رو.
Yeah. If something wrong, everybody knows.
هرچی اشتباه بشه همه میفهمن.
But you never know.
ولی نمیدونه آدم واقعا.
There's a joke. There's a joke. Okay.
Joke.
In a very famous country, there were three how you say police system. Yeah. Actually, they make fun of one country, but I don't want to name any country. So I just say, in a country, in a powerful country, there are three government controlling system, three kind of police departments.
توی یک کشوری که استاد اسمش رو نمیگن سه نوع مختلف سیستم پلیسینگ هستش که بخوان پلیس رو به اصطلاح اجرا بکنن پلیسینگ رو.
One is the government controlling police from the government. Yes.
یه سیستمی هستش که از طرف دولت این پلیسینگ پلیس بودن انجام میشه.
I mean direct from the presidential office.
مستقیما از طرف رئیس جمهور.
The most powerful. Yeah.
خیلی هم قدرت داره.
Okay. And the other one is a central investigation system.
سیستم
second powerful.
دومین قدرتی که برای همین پلیسینگ هستش چیز مرکزیه، پلیسینگ مرکزیه.
And the third is a normal police, a local police.
سومی هم هستش پلیس معمولی که محلی هستش.
And they are very famous for their efficiency. President of that country wanted to test them.
بعد نه باید به خاطر اینکه خیلی کاردان باشن توی کارشون از طرف رئیس جمهوری هم چک می‌شدن.
Okay. So he put a rabbit into a forest. And each time to tell one of these three police department to catch, to bring the rabbit back.
کاری که می‌کردن یه خرگوش رو می‌ذاشتن تو جنگل و به اون سه تا دپارتمان پلیس می‌گفتن که برین خرگوشه رو بیارین.
So the first one, the one direct from the presidential palace police, go in the jungle and make a big investigation.
گروه اول پلیسا که مستقیم از طرف رئیس جمهور بودن میرن توی جنگل و یک خیلی بررسی خیلی بزرگی انجام میدن در این مورد.
They rounded up all the animals in the forest and questioned them one by one.
تمام حیوانات توی جنگل رو جمع کردن، یکی یکی ازشون سوال کردن.
And they gathered all the rocks in the forest and questioned them one by one.
تمام سنگ‌های جنگل رو جمع کردن، یکی یکی ازشون سوال کردن.
And they questioned all the trees one by one.
تمام درخت‌ها رو یکی یکی سوال کردن ازشون.
And all the grass and the flower and the weeds in the forest. None of them are not questioned. They leave no stone unturned.
تمام گل‌ها، تمام چمن‌ها، همه رو ازشون سوال پرسیدن. هیچ چیزی رو جا نذاشتن. از همه چی سوال کردن.
Palace police. Yeah. Okay.
پلیس‌های طرف ریاست جمهوری.
After 3 months they concluded that rabbit doesn't exist.
بعد از 3 ماه به این نتیجه رسیدن که خرگوش وجود نداره.
Because all the tree don't know anything about rabbit, the rock say I don't know, and all the animals say we don't know.
به خاطر اینکه درخت‌ها گفتن ما چیزی نمی‌دونیم در موردش، سنگام چیزی نگفتن و حیوانات هم انکار کردن.
Okay. And the second best police, you know.
دپارتمان دوم که بهترین نوع پلیسشون بود.
And spying police. Also went into the forest.
رفتن به جنگل.
They cannot find the rabbit.
پیدا نکردن خرگوشو.
So they burned the whole forest.
تمام جنگل رو سوزوندن.
Get rid of the evidence.
تمام مدارک رو اینطوری از بین بردن.
We cannot find any evidence because the forest is burnt.
میگن ما هیچ مدرکی نتونستیم پیدا بکنیم و تمام جنگل سوخت.
And now came the third degree police, the local police.
حالا سومین نوع پلیس که پلیس‌های محلی اومدن تو کار.
From one of the cities in the country.
از یکی از شهرهای توی کشور.
He came in the forest, and then people saw them coming out with a bear.
بعد مردم دیدن که این پلیس‌ها دارن میان وارد جنگل میشن با خرس.
And the bear was beaten up very badly, bad shape, black and blue. The bear was beaten up.
بعد خرس رو هی کتکش میزدن.
Yeah, and the bear was screaming, "Okay, okay, I confess, I'm a rabbit. I'm a rabbit."
بعد خرسه اعتراف کرد اوکی 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 من دیگه خود خرگوش هستم.
Yeah, So you never know, but it's just a joke, okay? Your country is not like that. I hope, I think your country is more enlightened. Yeah, yeah. Go ahead.
Bad thinking before action is karma or not?
Yeah, can be or can be not. You see, sometimes it's a bad karma from the past life. Sometimes the karma from the action we made when we were younger in the olden day. Sometimes we are influenced by the people around us or from the thing that we see, from the thing that we read even. You know, like for example, people write some bad things. Just say pornography, for example. That's why people read them, because they like the feeling of when they read it. You understand? It feels real and it excites them. You see what I mean? If they don't read that, they wouldn't feel that excited. You see what I mean? So we are influenced also by the company we keep, by the society that we live in. And this is a very sad thing. So that's why we have to try to minimize what is no good for us. If we know it's no good, we don't contact anymore. We try to get in touch with any positive things possible that's good for us. But it's not always possible. So forgive yourself if you are influenced. We live in this world, you know, it's not always clean. So you just repeat the holy names of God all the time. And that's how you protect yourself. Yeah? Just get hold onto the string that Allah, contact with Allah, hold on that all the time, So that's how we can survive in this world spiritually.
سوال کردن که آیا فکر منفی قبل از اینکه کاری انجام بدی کردایی داشته باشی کارما داره یا نه؟ استاد گفتن بله، هم میتونه داشته باشه هم نداشته باشه. مثلا اگزامپلی که دادن، مثالی که دادن این بودش که و گفتن امکان داره آدم خیلی تحت تاثیر اطرافیانش هم قرار بگیره و وقتی که یه مجله مثلا ناشایسته به دستش میرسه این میل درش به وجود میاد و اینا. ولی چیزی که مهمه اینه که شما 5 تا نیم و مرتب بگین و از خدا بخواین که شما را حمایت بکنه.
That's why advertisement work.
برای همینه که آگهی کردن، آگهی دادن کار میکنه و آدم اثر میذاره.
How many time you want to drink for example say a beer or a Coca-Cola just because you just saw it on television? Before that you didn't want anything, you did not think of it. You saw an advertisement and then you want to go in the fridge and get one and drink yourself.
چند بار شده که شما یهو حوض کردین، در واقع آگهی رو دیدین و خواستین برین یا آبجو بخورید یا کوکاکولا یه چیزی بخورین به خاطر اینکه اون آگهی رو دیدین میری سراغ یخچال و نوشابتون رو برمی.
I think your country is forbidden alcohol. You see? So you should feel very happy. At least you don't have this temptation. In your country, many good tradition.
توی مملکت شما این سنت خیلی خوبه.
Yeah, the old tradition I also like very much.
سنت‌های قدیمی رو من خیلی دوست دارم.
Yeah, for example, like many Islam country, they forbid alcohol, they forbid gambling, they forbid stealing, and they help each other. Even the government help to build houses for the poor. They really take care of their people. And I really admire the Muslim country for that. Every country should learn from that. In this fashion, I am also a Muslim.
در این مورد من هم یک مسلمان هستم.
Because in our group, we don't want any of this. We avoid.
به خاطر اینکه ما هم در گروه خودمون همه اینجور چیزها رو میذاریم کنار. هیچ کدوم از اینا رو نمیخوایم.
We live very much according to the Quran.
من همون چیزی رو که قرآن گفته قبول دارم.
Yeah, we share what we have.
با بقیه آدمای دیگه شریک هستیم همه چیزو.
We avoid violence, we avoid stealing, we don't drink alcohol, we don't steal. Yes.
احکامی رو که داریم ما دزدی نمی‌کنیم، از مواد از الکل و مواد استفاده نمی‌کنیم و دروغ نمی‌گیم.
And in Muslim country, there's one thing also very good. It's the woman dress very decently, very discreetly.
یه چیز دیگه هم که تو کشورهای مسلمان خوبه من دوست دارم اینه که خانم‌ها لباس پوشیده میپوشن و خودشونو تا اندازه‌ای یعنی اندازه خوبی میپوشونن.
It has a very good point.
این یک پوان خیلی خوب داره.
But some of the world people don't understand it.
ولی بعضی ها تو دنیا اینو درک نمیکنن.
See when they dress like that, people have more respect for them. They don't look upon women as an object, a sexual object, but as an equal human being.
وقتی اینطوری لباس میپوشی مردم به شما بیشتر احترام میذارن و اون موقع شما رو به عنوان یک وسیله به عنوان سکس و وسیله سکسی نمیبیننتون.
That is to protect women.
این برای حمایت کردن زن هاست.
To give them more respect.
که بیشتر احترام بهشون گذاشته بشه.
But if it's too much, then people translate it into like restriction or to forbid controlling, but it's not like that. In the time of Prophet Muhammad, it doesn't mean like that. It's not restriction. It's not controlling.
اگر خیلی به حد زیاد برسه این امکان داره به این صورت تفسیر بشه که حالت کنترلینگ زیاد داشته باشه، محدودیت زیاد داشته باشه، ولی در زمان حضرت محمد اصلا اینطور نبوده.
Yeah. See how much war has happened, how much trouble has happened just because woman has not been respected as another creation of God but as a sexual object. So many war had happened because of that.
خیلی از جنگ‌ها به خاطر این انجام شده بوده که واقعاً خانم‌ها اونقدر بهشون احترام نگذاشته بودن و به عنوان یک جنس سکسی بهش نگاه می‌کردن.
Yes. In the Quran, the Prophet even said, yeah, it's very clear in the Quran why the Muslim woman should dress decently, you know, more discreetly.
توی قرآن توضیح دادن که چرا یک زن مسلمون باید درست حجاب داشته باشه و خودش رو بپوشونه.
You know everything about Quran already. I just talk for the ignorant non-Muslim, okay?
من میدونم که شما در مورد قرآن میدونید. من برای کسانی که اسلامو نمیشناسن دارم توضیح میدم.
So that they have a clearer understanding.
اون وقت بهتر میتونن متوجه بشن.
Sometimes they don't ask but they ask in their heart and so I want them to know. The Prophet say that in some regulation, you know, relaxing. For example, if a woman is very old already, or if she's with her relatives, like a nephew or something, but she's old already, and if he want to come in and ask her some question, then she can also relax the dress code, that she don't have to wear such a very covering dress, but a relaxing one, as long as she doesn't show her charm, I mean doesn't show the figure too much. How clear? Yeah.
مثلا اومده که اگر یک خانومی سنش هم بالا باشه ولی توی اتاق بعد مثلا برادرزادش بخواد بیاد، این مجبور نیستش که خودشو خیلی بپوشونه، فقط کافیه به اندازه کافی خودشو بپوشونه و در این مورد یک رعایت هایی رو بکنه.
Yeah. I mean the outer dress, you know, the big and non-shaped one, she can take that off
معمولا
in her private quarter.
جایی که هستش به اصطلاح خصوصی هستش، اون لباسی رو که گشاد هستش اونو میتونه در بیاره که بتونه حتی یه ذره مثلا اندامش هم نشون بده، این اشکال نداره برای کسی که نزدیکشه.
So that's very clear.
این خیلی مشخصه.
The Prophet aware of the power of the woman's charm which caused trouble for herself and for others.
کاملا پیامبر آگاه بودن از جذبه خانوم ها و اینکه این امکان داره این جذبه باعث دردسر بشه برای آقایون.
So later maybe they were more strictly with the way and everything, but perhaps beginning just enough to cover yourself a little and then enough to wear a whole like a uniform cover loose outfit like the one I wear in Hungary, for example.
اوایلش اینطور نبوده که اینقدر محدودیت داشته باشن خانم ها. امکان داشت یه لباس گشاد فقط میپوشیدن کافی بود که به اصطلاح کلشون رو بپوشونه، ولی بعدها خیلی محدودیت ها بیشتر شد.
In my opinion, that also very helpful. In the beginning, we advise all the women to wear up to here and all that. But we live in such a modern world. If I impose too much restriction, that would be too tiring for everybody already.
شاید در زمانهای گذشته این مشکلی نبوده که همچین محدودیت‌ها رو بذاریم، ولی من الان نمیتونم بخوام تو این دور زمان مدرن که همچین محدودیت‌ها رو روی بقیه بذارم، نیازی نیستش.
But at least I can say one thing, your attitude is very important.
حداقل یه چیز رو میتونم بهتون بگم، بینشتون خیلی مهمه.
It's not just the dress.
فقط این لباس نیست که مهمه.
You understand, yeah? Okay. So at least dress yourself with dignity.
پس با تواضع لباس بپوشید.
Yeah, at least dress yourself in dignity.
لباستون رو همون، یعنی با درست لباستون رو بپوشید.
Yeah, okay. So some people might say, oh, Muslim is too restricted and all that. But what is the good of alcohol? What's the good of drug? What is the good of cigarette doing to you? Even if you are not Muslim.
خیلی آدم ها هستن میگن چرا مسلمان ها اینطوری لباس میپوشن، خانم ها اینطوری لباس میپوشن. وقت یکی سوال میکنه میگه که پس چه پس الکل خوردن و سیگار کشیدن و مواد استفاده کردن اینا چرا، اینا خوبه مگه؟
yeah.
اینا چه خوبی داره؟
What do you miss? What do you miss?
چه چیزی رو شما از دست میدید؟ چه چیزی رو جاشو خالی میبینید؟
And gambling will make you bankrupt and broke your family.
وقتی که با ما بازی میکنی یه عالم پول از دست میدی، اصلا خانواده از هم میپاشه.
Put you in jail even if you have no money to pay. If you lose all the money.
حتی اگه پولاتو از دست بدی میذارن تو زندان.
Alcohol make you lose intelligence and dignity and control.
الکل هوشمندی تو از بین میبره، کنترل تو از بین میبره.
Cigarette drug make you sick.
و سیگار و مواد تو رو مریض میکنن، بیمارت میکنن.
Yeah. So you're not missing anything.
پس شما چیزی رو از دست نمیدین.
Yeah. I think many countries should forbid all this item. I think they are going to.
به نظر من خیلی از کشورها باید اینا رو قدغن کنن و این کارو میکنن.
It's getting in there.
داریم به اونجا میرسیم.
Yeah. Many countries now restricted on alcohol, labor, selling cigarette, restriction all the time. We are getting all Muslim.
خیلی از کشورها الان دارن منع میکنن الکل و سیگارو.
Okay. So actually we have to look at the positive side of everything.
پس باید به جنبه مثبت چیزا نگاه کنیم.
I think you should not be afraid. Any people live under Muslim government should not be afraid. They are safe.
هیچ کسی نباید نگران باشه. حتی دولت ها امنن. همگی امنن.
Even if they don't learn Kuan Yin method, at least they are safe.
حتی اگر از متد کوانین هم استفاده نمی کنن اونا امنن.
Sit here is better. Come on. It's only a cushion. Sit is better for you. You're not used to with sitting on the floor.
We are used
too
to.
Long.
Used
you
to.
Are?
We are used to. Yeah, we sit on the floor.
Oh, okay, you pray in 5 times a day. I know. It's very good system. At least you're praying every day.
استاد میفرمایند 5 بار در روز نماز خوندن خیلی خوبه.
If people are so disciplined like that, at least they always remember God.
اگر مردم این کارو میکنن اینقدر انضباط دارن، پس به یاد خدا هستن.
Very good system.
سیستم خوبیه.
In the beginning it was like meditation, you know. 5 times because half an hour break, half an hour, so become 2.5 hours. That's why five times.
اوایل در واقع برای مدیتیشن پنج بار بود. پنج تا نیم ساعت میشه دو ساعت و نیم.
Yeah, we don't have time to meditate a lot.
به خاطر اینکه زمان نبودش که ما بخوایم خیلی مدیتیشن بکنیم.
And during the Prophet Muhammad time, they've been harassed and they've been chasing from one country to the next, so they can only make a quick meditation half an hour each time.
پس در زمان حضرت محمد به خاطر اینکه انقدر اذیتشون میکردن دنبالشون میکردن از این ور به اون ور خیلی سریع باید نیم ساعته مدیتیشن و مراقبهشون رو میکردن و میرفتن.
And do you remember how you pray in the mosque?
Yes, و الان یادتون میاد که شما چطوری نماز میخونین و تکبیر میگید؟
Just one inch different.
Yes, it's the Kuan Yin.
Yeah, okay.
Yes.
Because in the old time, it's very restricted for the Muslim. Just like even now, we are restricted in different ways. So they have to have a code, you know, when they see each other together, they know this is, you know? Or maybe they do like this, but then the outsider, they don't know the secret. So they just look at what they're doing like that, so they come home and they do this, and then say, that's just Muslim, and then they continue tradition. After the Prophet died, nobody know the difference.
اوایلش که مراقبه میکردن در واقع همون مراقبه کوانین رو میکردن و به خاطر اینکه با هم دیگه نشون بدن که دارن به اصطلاح کوانین میکنن یا سلامایی به خصوصی میکنن اینو نشون میدادن اما بعدها کپی کردن چون نمیدونستن دارن چیکار میکنن وقتی حضرت محمد رفتن از این دنیا اونا کپی میکردن و تبدیلش کردن به یه چیز دیگه.
Yeah, just like the Christian.
مثل مسیحی ها علامت کراس رو که انجام میدن.
What do they do in the church?
توی کلیسا کاری رو که انجام میدن.
Wisdom eyes, five
چشم سوم، پنج اسم و کوان یین.
That's a secret code. They greet each other.
این کد رمزی بود.
But then later on it go down. Mm-hmm.
بعد اون وقت بعد ما تبدیل شد به یه چیز دیگه.
And yeah, after 2000 years it keep going down all the time and now people don't know where to do anymore. And maybe longer if another 3000 years they do it down to the knee.
میگن شاید تا 3000 سال دیگه این علامت بیاد به پایین‌ترهای بدنم برسه.
Who knows? The longer, the lower. Huh? Okay. I'm just telling you the remnant of the proof of the Kuan Yin method.
من میخوام بهتون بگم که نتیجه مراقبه کوان یین در واقع چی بوده.
You will find it, you will understand it. Yes.
متوجه میشید وقتی که فهمیدید.
I'm not teaching you anything new.
چیز جدیدی بهتون یاد نمیدم من.
It just since time immemorial, this world is a physical planet, and everything spiritual come down here is a clash with the physical energy. So mostly have to be secretive.
به خاطر اینکه این دنیای فیزیکی هستش و چیز معنوی که بیادش پایین یک کلشی به وجود میاره، یک برخوردی به وجود میاره. برای همین این برخوردها، به خاطر این برخوردها باید همه چیز سری و رمزدار باشه.
I think all the Muslim people should not feel that their government are too controlling or too restrictive. They should not. Just relax.
من فکر میکنم کشورهای مسلمان نباید به این فکر بکنن که دولت‌هاشون دولت‌های کنترلی هستن و میخوان خیلی محدودشون بکنن. باید سعی بکنن که ریلکس کنن. باید خیلی آرامش داشته باشن.
Do like the old woman.
مثل اون خانم پیری که گفتن باشید.
It could be worse.
میتونه بدتر باشه همونی که گفتن پادشاه بعدی میاد.
Yeah. At least in your country you are alive, you free, you away from the poison. At least if you die, you die normally. You don't die by drug, you don't die by alcohol, you don't die by tuberculosis with the cigarette, etc.
اقلن شما تو کشورتون آزادی دارین، زنده هستین و به خاطر الکل استفاده از الکل و الکل نمیمیرید.
That's why you look healthy and beautiful.
شما خوشگل هستید.
It's not a very favorable subject, but I want you to be happy under your circumstance, under your government, and you should feel lucky. So I talk a lot about this since you are here.
از اونجایی که شما اینجا هستید من میخوام که شما به خاطر دولتتون میخوام شما خوشحال باشید میخوام ریلکس بکنید در این مورد
Yes I think the Muslim country many government seem to be restrictive because they are protective of their people
من فهم میکنم کشورهای مسلمون اینطوری خیلی محدودن به خاطر اینکه خیلی میخوان مردم خودشون رو حمایت کنن
Yes Maybe in some cases overprotective, like some parents.
شاید در بعضی مواقع خیلی زیادی هم حمایت میکنم مثل والدین.
But it could not be. There are some places are worse.
اما جایی هم هستند که بدتر از اینجا هستند.
The government and the system of Muslim country, they worry that their people will get poisoned by a different system of thinking. By drinking alcohol if they get in touch with all the kind of system all the kind of thinking you understand me or getting drug and it's no good for them
میگن دولت های مسلمان نگران این هستن که مردمشون مثلا تحت تاثیر افکار دیگه قرار بگیرن مثلا مردمشون شروع کنن مشروب خوردن و این برای همینه که حمایتشون میکنن خیلی نمیخوان از خارج به اصطلاح هیچ تأثیری باشه روشون
Because look at the world, you know.
دنیا رو نگاه کنید الان.
Children are already drugged, addicted, sick when they're young already.
بچه‌های کوچیکی هستن که واقعاً مریضن و تحت تاثیر مواد مخدرن.
And the parents in the free country, they're helpless against all this.
و والدینشون توی کشورهایی که واقعاً آزاد هستن هیچ کاری نمیتونن در این مورد بکنن.
So at least In your country, your children are safe.
حداقل تو مملکت شما بچه‌هاتون در امن و در امنن.
Don't you think so?
فکر نمی‌کنی؟
Yeah. So it's a good system. It might feel restrictive in some way, but it's a good system.
امکان داره که فکر کنید که محدود باشید ولی سیستم خوبیه.
Yeah. I'm thankful that all the children in the Muslim country don't know anything about drug. Don't ever touch alcohol. Don't smoke cigarette. I'm so thankful. Even if they don't ever practice quanning method, at least they are free from all this poison. I'm very thankful to the Muslim system.
در یه سیستم مسلمون اقلا بچه‌ها تحت تاثیر سیگار، مشروب و مواد مخدر نیستن. حتی با اینکه کوانین انجام نمیدن. من به خاطر اینکه اینطوری حمایت بشن ممنونم.
And many other things like sexual harassment and all these kind of crime, you know, very little stealing, very little or almost none in Muslim country. Your children, your girls are safe.
یا حتی از دزدی یا حتی از دزدی یا حتی از تجاوزاتی به حریم جنسی در امانتر هستند تا خیلی از کشورهای دیگه.
Yeah. Look at it and be happy. Be grateful. Yeah.
خوشحال باشید و از خداوند تشکر کنید.
I teach you a great quantum method. But if your children are already drugged, already tired, already sick, or you are already sick because of drug, because of alcohol, very difficult for you to understand what I'm saying even. I have to de-poison you first. Yeah? Take a long time for your body to recover from poison, from drug, from alcohol. My God, it's a hard work for me. So, but if any Muslim he come, he already clean. Very easy. That's why I have good experience.
اگر حتی بخواید کوانین رو یاد بدیم به کسانی که تحت تاثیر مواد مخدر یا مشروب هستن من باید اینا رو اول سمومشون رو خارج بکنم تا اینکه اینا شروع بکنن به یاد گرفتن کوانین و تجربه بکنن برای همینه که شماها تجربیات خوبی دارید به خاطر اینکه دست به این آلودگی ها نمیزنید
Yeah, many people in so-called free country, non-Muslim country, they came to me, they're already sick. Burden with drug addiction, alcohol deterioration, their body, so many things.
خیلی ها از کشورهایی که از کشورهایی اومدن که غیر مسلمان بودن پیش من اومدن و مریض بودن به خاطر اینکه بدنشون تحت تاثیر شدید الکل یا مواد بوده.
So their thinking are not that clear, their mind are not that perfect.
فکرشون و ذهنشون اصلا باز نیست و ذهنشون اصلا درست کار نمیکنه، درست نیست.
But what I saw, this is very good government, you know. At least the government imposed that on their people. Not many countries use their leadership and power to impose good thing on their citizens.
این دولت خیلی خوبیه که میتونه این قدرت رو داشته باشه که این محدودیت ها رو بذاره.
But because they are afraid of the free world.
به خاطر اینکه دلیلش هم اینه که از به اصطلاح دنیایی که خیلی آزاده هست میترسن. به خاطر تاثیرش رو آدمای خودش.
Yeah, we the free world supposed to be a so-called free world also have ourselves to blame for making such a mess of our society with drug, alcohol and all kind of things.
ما همین دنیای آزادی که میگیم ما باید خودمون مقصر بدونیم به خاطر اینکه ما تقصیر داشتیم و مواد مخدر و الکل و این جور چیزا رو باعث شدیم که شیوع پیدا بکنه و موجود باشه.
Yeah. And with all this beautiful fashion our women are not safe on the street.
و با این همه به اصطلاح فشن و مد و اینایی که هسته جای خانم ها توی خیابون ها در امن و امان هستن.
So of course the Muslim government are afraid to let their citizens to come too much in contact with this kind of system. I don't blame them.
برای همینه که دولت میترسه از اینکه مردم خودش با همچین فکرها و به اصطلاح متدهای مختلفی که خارج هستش تماس داشته باشن.
Too much freedom.
که اینم به خاطر آزادی زیاده.
Maybe they have little freedom but the free will have too much freedom. We should balance. It will be better.
شاید شما کم آزادی داشته باشی و دنیای خارج خیلی آزادی ولی این دوتا اون وقت همدیگر رو به توازن میرسونن.
Yeah, it's difficult but we're getting in there.
مشکله ولی ما دیگه به اونجا خواهیم رسید. به اون توازن.
But I think any Muslim government would feel that you are safe with me.
من فکر میکنم هر دولت مسلمونی فکر میکنن که شما با من در امن و امان هستید.
Yes. Because we also live in according to the discipline of the Quran.
به خاطر اینکه ما هم با انضباط قرآن زندگی میکنیم.
Almost because the modern time is a little difficult.
تقریبا به خاطر موجودیت دنیای مدرن.
Yeah.
باید چیزایی رو در نظر بگیریم.
Okay. You can ask question now.
خب. حالا میتونین سوال کنین.
دیروز من در مراقبم تمرین تجربه‌ای داشتم که چون فکر می‌کنم به همه این جماعت مربوط میشه می‌خواستم اجازه بگیرم و اونو بگم.
In my meditation yesterday I had an experience and I think because it is related to everyone here I like to ask for your permission to share it with you.
Okay.
من دیروز در مراقبه دیدم که شما منو به سطح بالاتری ارتقا دادید و مطمئنم که برای همه این کار رو کردید اینجا و از طرف خودم و همه میخوام از شما تشکر کنم.
I saw in my experience that you elevated me to a higher level of consciousness and I'm sure you have done this for everybody here so I'd like to thank you for that.
You're welcome, welcome. Very welcome.
ما به ما یاد دادید که برای ارتقا به سطوح بالاتر از وابستگی ها باید دور بشیم. میخوام بدونم به یک قسمت خیلی سختی میرسیم و اون این که آیا باید از وابستگی به استاد هم چشم‌پوشی کنیم؟
You have taught us that in order to go to higher level of consciousness, we need to let go of the desires to belong, which we belong to this world. The question is, do we get to a point that we have to let go of our master as well?
If you want. Yes, of course, you can let go of me. No problem. Anytime.
بله میتونین هر موقعی که خواستی.
Just before you can run, you hold my hand to walk first and later you run along.
قبل از اینکه بخوای بدوی من باید دستتون رو بگیرم. خیلی یواش یواش راه بریم ولی بعد میتونیم.
But you don't have to let go if you don't want to. We are friends. Why let go?
مجبور نیستی که منو رها بکنی. ما دوست هستیم. میتونیم همچنان با هم ادامه بدیم.
But let go physical attachment only, but spiritually we become one together.
از لحاظ فیزیکی رها کن وابستگی به من ولی از لحاظ معنوی ما یکی هستیم.
Not one like okay everything here is one, not one like that, but we're connected. Yeah.
نه به خاطر اون چیزی که یک هست یه چیزی هستی مثل این بطری بلکه ما اون وقت وصلیم.
Yes.
به هم وصلیم.
Connected. So that I can help you to go up where I am going.
من بتونم بهت کمک کنم که باز بری بالاتر.
Yeah, and it come one time that you become a master of yourself. But you let go like, I don't know, it depends on people, you know. I don't know if they can let go. After 20 years, they still crying when they see me. I don't understand these guys. So maybe you can teach them how to let go.
میگم بعد دیگه بستگی داره که آیا میخوای این کارو بکنی. ببین بعد از 20 سال اینا هنوز دارن گریه میکنن و نمیتونن رها کنن.
I guess we become like very deep friendship.
به نظر میادش که ما یه دوستانه دوستی خیلی عمیقی اون وقت خواهیم
داشت. So we will not feel attached about the physical body or nearness, but we feel very close together.
ما اون وقت احساس نمی کنیم که فیزیکلی به هم نزدیکیم ولی یک احساس نزدیکی دیگه ای داریم.
Yeah. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Any more?
Thank you. خوشحالم چون من نگران این بودم که شما بگید که باید دیگه به من وابسته نباشید.
I'm glad because I was worried that you would say no, you should not depend on me anymore after a while.
I should not depend?
Yeah, I'm glad that I don't have to let you go.
Oh, that's a different. It's not attachment. It's just the oneness of feeling.
احساسش احساس یکی بودنه. احساس وابسته بودن نیست.
Yeah. For example, some people they're so attached to alcohol, to money, that they worry all the time about these things, and they cannot even live their life, and they become slave of money or alcohol. That is true attachment.
استاد در مورد معنی وابسته بودن و گیر دادن به چیزی صحبت میکنن مثل اینکه آدم بخواد الکل استفاده بکنه و یا خیلی برده پول و الکل باشه این اون در واقع بردگی براش میاره این فرق میکنه
and they even destroy them.
حتی این باعث نابودی شخص میشه
but our friendship is make us both happy.
اما دوستی ما باعث میشه که ما رو شاد و خوشحال نگه می‌داره.
It's not like he cannot live without me, but he likes to live with me and to see me.
اینطور نیستش که بخواد منو رها بکنه، بلکه دوست داره با من زندگی بکنه.
See, the attachment is like some people who cannot live without woman. Every day he need, who cannot live without money. Every day he want more and more. That's different. We could live without each other. You go home, I stay here or somewhere else. We're not together, but you're happy. You think of me and you feel like we're together. And you like to see me now and again. It's okay. It's not attachment. It's just happiness. Enjoy each other. Yeah. That's an unconditional friendship. Yeah. If we see each other, we're happy. But if we don't see, we go home, we think of each other, not biding.
اگر ما با هم هستیم ما خوشحالیم همدیگر رو میبینیم و اگرم از هم جدا هستیم میدونیم که باز با هم دوستیم و این خوب
That's not attachment at all, okay?
این وابستگی نیست.
All right. And the thing is, the more we think of each other, the more we happy and more elevate. So it's a good thing.
هر چقدر بیشتر به هم فکر بکنیم بیشتر با هم نزدیک هستیم.
Okay. Any more question? We can ask again tomorrow or next day. Yeah. No, I'm too hot. And this Holland, Finland clothes is really killing me. I'm glad I could even get inside it. Yes. I love the loose outfit, the Hungarian.
Yes.
So whenever I get out of the retreat or I'm in my house, I always wear that. Sometimes, if I'm not with you or I don't have to advertise for clothes, I just wear that. I go to supermarket with it, go on airplane with it. You know, the Hungarian style, the Muslim-like, very straight.
استاد میفهمن اگه من مجبور نباشم به خاطر چیز تبلیغ کنم لباسای خودم تبلیغ بکنم و اینا من معمولا لباس آزاد میپوشم مثل لباس مسلمان ها مثلا میرم تو سوپرمارکت یا سوار هواپیما میشم با لباس آزاد میرم
the most comfortable clothes
به خاطر اینکه خیلی راحت
I think the Muslim people are very smart
من فکر می کنم خانم های مسلمان خیلی باهوش هم خیلی شیکن
convenient everywhere
همه جا خیلی راحت کارش رو انجام میدن راحت
yeah. And some people come up to me, and some Muslim woman come up to me. Because sometimes it's cold, I also put a scarf on my head and I wear that. So he come up to me and ask, are you Muslim?
شده که یه خانم مسلمان اومدن به طرف استاد و استاد سردشون بوده یه روسری گذاشتن سرشون. اومدن گفتن هم مسلمانی؟
I say yes, yes, yes.
استاد میگه بله, بله.
Yeah, I am, I am.
استاد میگه من هستم.
I am in a true spirit.